I'm Kyle Martin. I'm from Rock Springs, Wisconsin, and I am a plein air landscape painter. Plein air being French for in the open air, meaning that I paint landscapes on location. We're here in the Chicken Coop Studio, which is a converted chicken coop that has become my studio and my gallery to showcase my artwork. When I was young, I knew it as a place where we kept calves and sometimes heifers. I can remember one year it was Christmas Day and I was 10 years old and I was here shoveling manure into the manure spreader right out the window. So there's some varied memories between the farming days and now the painting days. I've been enjoying art and all things art related ever since I can remember.
Hi, Mom.
My father was a hardworking farmer and my mother worked 2 full-time jobs. When I came home and said that I wanted to go to college for art, they could have said, yeah, try something else. But they're actually extremely supportive. So I went to school for graphic design and illustration in Madison, and we also had a painting class. And that was my first introduction to painting in plein air. And after that day, that was it. I was just hooked. My work is dedicated to the memory of my father. Unfortunately, he passed away in a farming accident in 2008. He was very proud. And just knowing that he got to enjoy my work in that way was a very special thing. Just to know that. Welcome back to the channel. Skateboarding and painting are 2 big things in my life, and they're completely opposite, but they're intertwined as well. Skateboarding is just motion and freedom, and a lot of times you almost get to turn your brain off. And painting is the flip side of the coin because it's so intellectual and you're kind of static. Let's hold our value isolator up. Who can name that color? When I am teaching painting classes and when I'm making my YouTube videos, I'm kind of showing off the different tools that I use. My Door County workshops will be coming up at the Peninsula School of Art. I am gonna take the students out into the forest and I'm gonna give them the red glasses and we're gonna talk about the contrast of the light and the way that the light is affecting the foliage.
I have a 20% value at this point.
I came up with this very easy to use value palette that helps my students mix your colors to a specific value.
Do y'all see where the long grass is?
As an artist, he sees that. And most of us don't even realize we're seeing that. But he makes it happen and the painting is beautiful.
I think my mission as a painter is really to capture the barns and the farms around the area.
I love the little piece of red barn paint that hung on under the roof.
Probably my favorite thing to paint would be a barn that is kind of coming down. You know, it used to be something, and now it's in this state of transition. When you're chasing the golden hour light, you're just kind of acting as something that's in between the landscape and the finished painting. And to me, the reason to paint is to show that energy of that time of day.
It's just, nothing is better.
But part of it too is that when you're in the country, you just will not be bothered for a couple of hours. And you can just stand there and do your thing. The Fall Art Tour is an event that happens the 3rd weekend in every October. People drive around and check out the workspaces of various artists who are in the area.
I keep coming back to that one.
It's the longest running studio tour in the Midwest, and that's probably my favorite way to show paintings. When you come down the driveway to the farm, and then you step into the chicken coop, it's a different environment from where the people came from. And it's just great to be able to share the sort of life. A lot of times, it'll take people a few minutes just being around my work to really start to see it or understand it. Watching them kind of go through that transition is really an exciting thing.
It's very
thank you for coming. See you again sometime.
I think we live in a time when activities like skateboarding and creating artwork are very valuable things. I just think if you're a person who ever wanted to paint, or if you're a person who ever wanted to skateboard, give it a shot. Just do it. The first step is just doing it. You don't have to know anything. And if you like it, do it again tomorrow.
Whoa.